The love of two hearts beat as the lapping upon the shore, the herald of the royal seat as the storm that shakes the sky, the maiden of the forest spring as the flame attracts the fly, the lion's claw and dove's wing, eventually both will die.
Thank you. told of ancient days when wise priestess Beala Tirin to goddess Lyria spoke. The people, remembering all after war, called for Durek's fate. "Slay them, the foul and wretched tribe," said Docolfar. "Spare them, the poor and miserable beasts," cried Losolfar. Their minds, depraved and hatred-poisoned, twisted. Alfar struck Alfar over drink, at feast, when all else is merry, when peace reigns in havens. Hateful, I am told, were cousins towards each other. From the cold-blessed Firiol, Beala Tirin, with a head to seek Lyria's guidance, set forth on a pilgrimage.
I say, isn't there anything we can do about all this uncivilization in these lands? We have magic and weapons. Should be easy work. But you could fit the bill. I'm part of an expedition to the teeth of Naros, and we need another to come with us on the journey. The Cranwyns helped found the Order of the Ash. Our caliber of spells is matched only by our fortitude, as I'm sure you've heard. An ominous name. Naros is a troll god. If this is a place trolls believe to be hallowed ground, then what are we getting ourselves into? This is rather base work for one of my stature. But if rumors of this southern land are true, then even among the Cranwyns I'll be reputed. The Varani woman? Helix seems to respect her, but I've a feeling she'll cheat the lot of us before this is through. It's as I said, we are going to the unexplored land south of Dalin. Our coffers will thank us when we get there. If you need more information, find our camp near...
Thank you.
My assistant has returned. What do you need of me? Stay safe.
Only one head, by the mercy of the gods. I thought my time had come at last. Fate does not seem to hold much stock in my expedition, but it leaves me alive to see its utter failure through to the end. I was leading an expedition to recover a pair of Arathi artifacts known only as Shine and Shadow. I've spent the last decade researching them. Texts say the artifacts are powerful, but what they can do is never explicitly stated. Regardless, the Templars feel it best to place such items under their guard. But the Etin have hit us hard. And it's said that the artifacts are guarded in Delac by an ancient, powerful shaman of their kind. I'm at a loss for what to do. I have not had such good news in some time. My research indicates that the artifacts are somewhere in Delac. It seems they're now a trophy of the Etin. I can promise you this much. Though my expedition was underprepared, it was not underfinanced. A large reward waits for one who finds the artifacts. I'm here from Odessa on business. The rest of my expedition was wiped out by the Etin. I came here strictly for research purposes. This is not a place many people would come on their own accord. Their impudence seems tied to their devotion. From what I can tell, a small number of prominent shamans are rallying them. If someone had a head on their shoulders and a blade, then toppling those shaman would help pacify the area. Can't say I know all that much about the old man, other than he's a fisherman here in Etinir. He's quite a hospitable man, though. He let me stay here without much question. My research has tracked them to Delac. There is talk of an ancient guardian.
Stranger? There ain't no fish today, stranger. It's best you look elsewhere. Ah, can't even look a fish in the face anymore. Not ever since I met that nymph. I can remember when I first saw her, on the cliff to the south, overlooking Etinmere. I saw that watery maiden and I fell in love with her. I've outlived my Imelda. My nephew Thaddeus up and left for Dyden Hill for want of never seeing me again. I had a chance of ending loneliness, but it was taken from me. The beasts of the wild scared her off. We were to wed by my pier, but I ain't seen her for days now. I'd search, but the monsters will rip me to shreds. I bet you could indeed, but that's only half of what's needed. You must also find my bride-to-be. Then the wedding will be upon us. I've got to find the ring. I need to find my bear mask. I need to prepare. You best start by the pier. If she's not there, keep heading south. She's bound to be somewhere. Go on now. I will ready myself for the wedding and then catch up to you. I was to meet her at the old pier, but the gentle creature got scared by the monsters, no doubt. I first laid eyes on her from the cliff overlooking the lake to the south. I bet if you head south, you'll still find her. Well, I've seen a few fine women in my day. Even met a fey woman in Gorhart long ago. But that nymph, she's something else. Her skin's luster, her heaving prow and ample stern. Except for the fishy parts, I mean. But even so, I've fished this lake enough that the form is pleasingly familiar. Not much here anymore besides the Etin and myself. We get the occasional traveller, but it's not often. I've been a fisherman on these shores since I could cast a net. Even the Etin leave me be. Used to be this was Holmes Lake. But I lost my wife Imelda to fever and my... And now I'm just a man content to die in the house my family built here years ago. They're hostile enough normally, but of late it seems like a... If they keep this up, we might have an Etin war party on our hands. If only someone might take... Please, find my nymph!
Valiant warrior, destroyer of Enfaminir, Duke of the Hylarans, protector of the Ring of the Old Man, discoverer of the island of Meropis, were he only to meet a better end.
My lovely bride.
I am all dressed and prepared for our wedding. Thank you, stranger. Bless you. Now, if you don't mind, I'm going to seal my bond with a ring and a kiss. Any last words for a crusty bachelor?
My nymph! She just felt that disgusting etching with a glance.
Beauty kills even the beast.
Did you not see her wiggle away to the cliff overlooking the lake? It's where we first met, you know. A grand spot for our union.
Well, friend, if there's nothing else, I'm off. You're welcome to witness the event if you care to. Love makes men do strange things, I'm not denying it. Yeah, I can tell my words fall on deaf ears. Hey, then I won't keep boring you with an old coot's rattle.
Mike, did you not see her?
Well, friend, if there's nothing else, I'm off. Here goes nothing.
Among our court, so virile in his living. He is fervent embodied. He is vitality. He rescued Princess Luna to take as his own. King of Strand, Prince of Passion.
My assistant has returned. What do you need of me? Good day.
So formidably bloody bones. Once companion to Issa, now enemy to the court. Once lover of Era, then bringer of death. Now forever in decay, forever cursed, never to enter the great cycle, forever alone.
My lovely bride. I am all dressed and prepared for our wedding. Thank you, stranger. Bless you. Now, if you don't mind, I'm going to seal my bond with a ring and a kiss. Any last words for a crusty bachelor? Please, find my nymph. There she is, my lovely bride. I thank you, stranger. Now, if you don't mind, I'm going to seal my bond with a ring and... My nymph! She just felt that disgusting etching with a glance. Beauty kills even the beast, so they say. Did you not see her wiggle away to the cliff overlooking the lake? It's where we first met, you know. A grand spot for our union. Well, friend, if there's nothing else, I'm off. You're welcome to witness the event if you care to. Wait a moment. That's no nymph. That's not the graceful creature I fell in love with. You were good enough to go along with an old man's wishes. Might I ask one more of you? I want you to kill that beast to preserve the memory of my bride. And I'll see you rewarded if you do. You've seen the chaos and destruction the thing has caused. It's a demon of the waters. Not only that, but... To think I ever loved that thing. It's shameful. Please, it burns my old heart. I reward you for the work. I promise you that much. Just see it gone. I'd rather not talk about it, stranger. My personal failings tend to make me upset. Farewell.
Antipathy between them, Ferrara and Feymor. Ferrara filled with life in bloom, and the bloody bones with rot and scorn. How terrible is their grapple when they both meet their ends.
You must finish. That's the end of that, then. I'm sorry for roping you into such a task, Straight. It's just, you see enough sadness in your life, and you see chances for happiness wherever you look. Now for your reward. Take my wedding ring. Based on Imelda's memory long enough, seems fair I give up what hasn't been taken. It ain't much. Just a small charm that she had when we were wed. When fever took her, I mounted it on her grave. And then one of those two-headed bastards pried it off, carried it to the lake, giggling like a pair of fools. Wouldn't dare follow the beasts there. But if you... well, you've helped me enough. Thank you. You're a kind soul indeed. The Etin took to the shore as soon as I saw him. He's somewhere on the lake's edge, I'm sure of it. A fisherman on these shores. Used to be this was the Holmes Lake, and now I'm just an old man content to die in the house.
Look at what we have here. Truthfully, I never expected to see another civilized soul out here in Etenmere. Something about the giant hairy monsters must keep people away. Good to meet you. The name is Ray Kildene, purveyor of fine sagecrafting goods and friend to the House of Ballads. Sure, Wenson and me are close friends, like brothers. He doesn't mind at all if I camp outside the oratory here. Just so long as I clean up my mess. Apparently he's a legendary knight of the House of Ballads, its ruler. But I've never seen him slay anything. He doesn't even own a crown. It's a mystery to me, Fae come and go, but none of them ever pay me much mind. A while back, one of them dropped something in passing. They called it a cairn. I had it in my possession for one glorious night, before they pried it from my grip. Magic, I suppose. They don't seem to do much of anything on their own. I heard Wenson mention something about an Echo Stone, but I don't know what that is. Sounds like trouble to me. I've been out here for weeks. Getting in is the easy part. It's getting back out that will get you killed. Lucky for me, Wenson and his friends have their oratory out here. Whatever an oratory is, they've never let me inside. I don't call any one village or city home. No, I'm a wanderer by nature, a merchant by trade. Most people just assume it's... Actually, it's because my wife wants me dead. If the two of you ever meet, don't tell her you found me. Please. She's terrifying.
Yeah. Oh, It's good you're here. I was beginning to think you were just something I saw in the bottle. Welcome to the ruins of Delok. Because for some reason, you can change fate. In here, I can get a glimpse of the whole of the Weave and see where you should fit in. Yes, it doesn't look like much, but in these ruins lies the Theater of Fate. The ancient home of the Fate Weavers. Come with me. No telling what we'll find down there. He died before his time, but I can't imagine many tears will be shed for him. You tell enough futures, and soon you won't have any friends left. The Theater of Fate was once an Irathi stronghold. Mortals and immortals worked together to build a site of total understanding. Since then, it's been lost, rediscovered, and abandoned all over again. Mortals can't stand the knowledge, and immortals simply don't care. Ah, the warm and welcoming Fae of the Summer Court. They were the ones who welcomed Man, Alfar, and Gnome into the Fae lands. You'd hardly realize the Tuatha are the same sort of creature. Everyone thinks the immortal Fae are enigmas, but they've got it all wrong. The Fae are simple, far simpler than mortals. They never change. Even when their bodies die, they reform again, often years later. It's the ruins of the Theater of Fate. This is where the first Fate Weavers learned how to read the weave. They left. I'm hoping that the stone will tell me who you are. In we go.
Mm-hmm.